Did you know, Philippine independence was finally realized when the United States officially proclaimed it on July 4, 1946. President Manuel Rojas, in his first State of the Nation address, detailed the challenges the country was facing in the aftermath of war. A new Republican and Democratic government, the Third Republic of the Philippines, was inaugurated with Manuel Rojas as president. Let's proceed to the post-independence under Manuel Rojas administration, our main topic. The administration of Manuel Rojas saw several developments that indicated the beginning of neocolonialism in the Philippines. In an effort to solve the massive socio-economic problems of the period, President Rojas reorganized the government and proposed a wide-sweeping legislative program. It was under his administration that the Bell Trade Act was passed and the 1935 Constitution amended, which gave the Americans parity rights and access to Philippine resources and industries. During the Rojas administration, the Philippines established diplomatic ties with foreign countries and gained membership to international entities such as the World Health Organization or WHO and the International Labor Organization or ILO. President Rojas moved to strengthen sovereignty by proposing a central bank for the Philippines to administer the Philippine banking system, which was established by Republic Act No. 265. Meanwhile, the Military Bases Agreement also gave the Americans access to military bases throughout the country and allowed them sovereignty within the territory of these bases. One of the greatest challenges to the Rojas government was the spread of socialism and the growth of socialist and communist groups that supported the cause of workers and farmers. The Hukbalahap or Hukbong Bayan Laban sa Hapon was a socialist or communist movement formed by the farmers of Central Luzon. They are popularly known as the Huks. It started during the Japanese occupation of the Philippines in 1942 and continued during the presidency of Manuel Rojas. A campaign of violence was instigated against these groups and the Rojas administration was accused of attempting to suppress the Huks and their allies. This led to widespread violence in the provinces, particularly in Central Luzon. The Huks considered the government as a tool for the vested interests of the elite and the United States. On April 15, 1948, following a speech before an audience of assembled airmen at Clark Field Air Base, President Rojas died of a heart attack.